So today I'm gonna tell you about a night that my friends and I know as Poison Night. It all started when I came home from school one day and I had a half empty bottle of Snapple. And I used to keep a handle of gin inside the house at all times. We mixed it together, put some vodka in it, and we called it poison. When we started the night, we had a rule. Anyone who drank from poison had to put something into poison. We took it to a party and that was so stupid. Like, I would never do that now. We went inside and, you know, it was just a standard college party, you know, something questionable inside the bathroom sink. People are dancing to some shitty music. There came a point in the night where everybody found themselves on the roof. There was a window and we could crawl through it and get onto the roof. It was badass. It was really cool. Me and my roommate that had initially made the poison, we saw this girl up there and she was really cute. We told her the rules of poison. She was like, oh, okay, that sounds really neat. She didn't get a chance to drink any though, because there was this guy there. He was like this preppy guy, tall, black, handsome, viciously drunk. Hell yeah, I want some poison. He grabs the poison from us and he drinks some. And he drank a good bit of it. I was like, you know, you gotta put something in when you drink. That's the rules. I didn't get a chance to explain it to you. And he was like, okay. He did put something in there. You know what he was drinking that night? Beer. So a quarter of our Snapple poison drink was now beer. Try putting beer in your next mixed drink. Yeah, I didn't give any to this girl because I didn't want her to drink that. I just held on to it. Outside there were people doing a lot of cocaine, furiously doing cocaine. There was this one guy, I won't forget him because he was the most disgusting person I've ever met. He waited till all these people were done. He ran his fingers everywhere and he put it like in his lips and shit. He was just acting crazy after that. He was like, I'm thirsty, I'm thirsty. He grabbed my Snapple bottle with the poison in it and he drank some. It was disgusting because there were these little pieces of white stuff inside it, and I wasn't sure if it was like cocaine or like little pieces of spit. I threw the bottle away after that. I didn't feel right handing it out and people taking a sip of I mean, I would have been drugging people. Oh yeah, I threw up on the roof, and then we left. This was before Uber was like a big thing in Reno, so I didn't call an Uber. I wish I'd called an Uber. I saw one of my classmates there. She was having a good time. Let's just put it that way. She offered to drive us home, which if I had been sober, that would have been a red flag, but I wasn't. It was not a very long drive, but she was swerving. I don't know why I thought it was fun at the time, but now they think back, that's really scary. Like, really scary. I could have died. I was just happy to get a ride home instead of walking. By the time we got to our place, one of my roommates had passed out. We had to drag him up to the apartment and throw him inside the tub. But I got into bed all right, and I had a pretty good night's sleep. That's the story of poison. Tell your friends not to do that, because that was very dangerous. Seriously, if I can part with one message, it would be don't do any of that. That was really stupid. I'm by no means cool by telling this story. In fact, I'm... Stay safe out there.